Welcome to the Cat Collective. I'm Nina. I'm the channel for this channel, and let's start. Whale song resonating. And lay of the land. Ancestral wisdom. Okay. Gonna pull some more cards, of course, as always. The muffin. Really? The head in the clouds, right? Yeah, exactly. Oh, okay. Oh, of our roots. So I'm getting that. You've been alone for quite some time, because look at those two cards. The whale is inside of a bubble, and this figure is standing alone, right, on this mountain, and well, you've been alone for a while, but now something has changed where you have been introduced to other energies. But what, first let's explore what being alone does to you, you know? So when you're alone and you really don't see anyone, I'm really getting a very solitude energy. You are just inside your own bubble, right? And you are just resonating with yourself, in a way. But whenever I see this, I also get reminded of what you do when you are with yourself. You think a lot, you know, if you look at that, right? Think a lot about what you could do. To get out of there. This is always a gaining access to something card. It's a green card, right? And yes, you might talk to yourself a lot. Could be, right? That's my cat, Major Tom. He's also introducing his energy into this reading. Yes. Yes. Okay. Now he said everything. And I notice the hair of him on the card. Yeah, so when you are isolated for a long time, it can be so challenging for some people, that they get into a very depressed state. But you were not really that depressed. I'm seeing it with this figure. This figure is standing up and just, in a way, embracing the loneliness a bit. Can be also that you are now, that you came to the conclusion that it's a nice place to be, you know, because when you are in your own bubble, no one else interferes with it. I'm getting it with this card. You know, sometimes when we are surrounded by other people, we take on their energies, especially when we are empaths. And we become like them, right? A little bit. And that's sometimes not the best place to be in, right? It's just whenever I see this song thing, I'm thinking about your goals, you know? And it could be that this overthinking process has led you to also not being so motivated, not being that motivated that you would love to be when you are alone, because when you are alone, theory, you have got all the time in the world, right? And you wanted to work on so many things, but you did not do it all. Instead, I'm seeing at this. So you clearly worked on your healing also. What I'm getting with this is just that also when you're feeling lonely, you engage in addictions maybe, which are not very nice. This is a judgment, you know, it's just sometimes addictions are just there because we try to cope with a situation that is not 100% how it appears to be. So clearly this situation of being alone, which you enjoyed very much, appears to be great and you enjoyed it, right? Or maybe you still enjoy it, but it's also the cause of something unhealthy in your life. It could also just mean that you are having thoughts that are destructive, you know? I'm getting this feeling when you are in your own energy. If you look at those two cards, this figure and this figure, they are almost the same. They are mirroring each other with the posture almost, right? And they bounce off of each other. So when you are in a room and you just bounce off of yourself, you amplify yourself, right? You amplify your own energies, and suddenly this card looks like you're standing on your own darkness, because you've been bouncing off of yourself for a long, long time, and that's a realization to have, right? Because you were, in a way, enjoying yourself. But I'm sure you're also aware of this situation, you know? When you just... what I'm also getting is when you put a microphone too close to the amp, with the song, then it makes this woo sound, right? And this is when you are with yourself, you know? When you amplify yourself, that's what's happening too, energetically. You also bounce off of yourself a bit more, right? And yeah, it's not that great in a way, right? Because hey, if you have ever heard a sound like this amp that was too close to the microphone, right? It's not a nice sound. It's transforming your head into this. And also, you know, even though I think there are a million different interpretations for this card, but when I look at this, it's also when you are too deep in your own dream world and in your own amplified version of yourself, you know, it's transforming you. You are then inside of this container, and it's not evolving as much, and you are just spiraling into your own energy, right? Even though you wish, probably, that you would receive an offer with boots. Maybe you also have been dreaming about, you know, ripping yourself out of this place, you know, with this hand, pulling the flowers out of the soil. and yeah, removing yourself from the situation, right? So let's see what we get. The cards want to speak, okay? Okay. Yeah, that okay, I'm getting already, you know, this is you looking out into the horizon. This is a cups card, so with your cup, you know, you hold your cup and you do you see that? The flowers? You hold this flower, and this flower represents a yearning of connection, I think, and also nature. You know, see this. You wish you could not just bounce off of your own energy, but also of nature and. You're just looking out at the landscape, and she doesn't look too happy for me today. She just looks silent, right? But she also you know, her skin merged with the background. That's always interesting for me. That's interesting, yeah. Okay. So there seems to be someone arriving on your scene. Do you see that? But you don't know who this is. That's interesting. Because of all the armor he's wearing, right? He's bringing a flag. I could also represent that you wish that someone would come because she's looking out, you know, and she's like, oh. Can't just someone come to my space? Someone who's wearing the same colors, right? So the cards are in Spanish, so I don't know what cards this is, but it looks a bit like King and Queen of Cups, but I'm not sure because those are all both cups, copas, but Caballero and Sota, I'm not sure. But that's reflecting the uncertainty for me today. But they clearly have got the same color scheme, you know, and he's the colors of the nature also. It's very nice. And yeah, that's lovely. I just got something, but I lost it. Oh yeah, the uncertainty with the moon, this huge moon. It's this dreaming of things, you know, it's this dreaming of, it's embracing your own dreams, you know, this could be also, again, your bubble, but as I said, it can come to a point where you resonate, where you amplify yourself too much. Another person. No, this could be the king. See, is someone just showing himself, you know? So it's also a cup card. But this could be the knight then. I will look up the meanings of Spanish words, but this is a... He looks so sad, doesn't he? So it could be that someone is being revealed to you. Maybe you looked up, you watched out, you know, and saw someone wearing armor, right, and a flag. You recognize them, and you know. They're being revealed to you. You see them and you see also their sadness. Oh, it's beautiful in a way, right? You see that they are a king, but they are so sad, right? And those are clouds, right? he's also surrounded. Oh, it could be that you meet someone who is also surrounded by their own cloud, just like you are, also amplified. Someone who also has been amplified, like you did, you know, with yourself. Someone who's been through the same. Because it's just, if you look at this, it looks almost like one image, right? But if you also look at this, it could also be that you just dream of someone like this. Or that this encounter is not 100% just happening in the 3D. Because, you know, when you see this as one image, which I think is clearly, well, it's, you know, with all those colors, it really looks like one image. She's dreaming and wishing for the king to come in with her flower, right? Oh, that's beautiful. It's beautiful. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, now I'm getting this. You know, she's dreaming of someone and making up who they could be. Oh, suddenly I get so sad. It's like, you know, she's wishing for this person to finally arrive. But suddenly, you know, the dreams get darker because of the amplification of self, you know, because it's time. It's time that he's being revealed. Because if you look at that, I don't think that this flower she's holding has got a root. And a flower without a root will just die, right? And she's wishing for the offer with roots to come in finally, even though she doesn't know who the knight is, you know? Because look at that, love that. Because he is not surrounded by a cloud or by thoughts or, you know, he's standing there in front of her, like manifested 3D. And that's what she did previous to that. It's like manifesting someone into your life, right? In solitude. Yeah. Hold on. And again, the thoughts. I love that, though. This idea of the cards merging and just revealing. There's someone coming in. Who's that, right? Don't know. And be assured that this person is on his or her way. It can flip. You can flip the genders however you need it. And, yeah. Huge sword. It's, you know, it's the, I'm getting this, you know, thoughts are all about thoughts. And today I'm seeing this as, you know, the thoughts that have been overgrown by the dream of this happening, right? Because there are also flowers down there. And he's so sad. So it could be that if you're feeling sad, that you're also picking up his sadness, because, you know, when you have a deep soul connection, you see that you are connected, even in the card, you know. So it could be that you're picking up each other already before you even meet, right? Oh, that's so beautiful. And that's what's keeping your thought process growing and expanding, but it also feels so, if you take this card and put it on there, it feels so, that's why I probably got the sadness. It's this, that it, the king needs to be revealed soon, because even though the thoughts are beautiful and growing, it's painful to have an encounter with the sword, right? Yeah. Oh, I love that. Okay, let's see if I can pull another card. A new earth. It's happening. Keep holding the vision. Wow. That's a good... I don't even need to pull more cards, because if you look at that, this is the moon, right? The uncertainty, and she's embracing it, right? She likes to dream, right? She likes to dream about this, and there it, you know, she's dreaming and holding the hands up like that, right? She's holding the hands up and amplifying in her own bubble. But look at that. Then it transforms. This version transforms into this clarity, you know? That's the earth. And she's standing there, and it feels like... Can you imagine when you finally see... when you finally see who is there for you, right? When finally your uncertainty becomes certain, you see that it's happening, how overwhelmed you are about this, how frightening it also could feel, and how much respect you have of this situation when suddenly this huge planet comes to rushing towards you, right? And this huge planet is this fella, right? This one, right? Yeah. It's this. Suddenly you are not alone anymore, and it comes, you know, the world is suddenly, you are connected, right? Oh, I love that. But it feels scary, because she's standing in all the water and looking at the stars, and they are so close in this image, right? They are closer than the earth, right? I love that. It feels big. Of course, look at that. It's just like, I'm getting how breathless she stands there, witnessing this, you know, because it comes from your own consciousness, the water, the dreams, becomes real, right, and manifested. Oh, love that. Okay, let's see if there's a moonology card that wants to be pulled. A new start is coming. Okay, so there's nothing more to say. And you're very close to achieving your goal. Yeah, well. Yeah. I'm gonna pull another card where every card has the same meaning. The meaning is everything's going to be okay. So, now let's see who this ring is for. I'm a Taurus. I'm suddenly noticing all the gold, because I've edited the cards a bit. I will edit the backgrounds again, because some of them are a bit dirty from the drawing process. I think there's another one that's dirty. This one there. A little bit in there. There's a bit dirt. And I'm just noticing that with the gold. Just added a little bit of gold. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe it means something to you because I was noticing. Yeah, so I hope you enjoyed the reading and see you next time. Bye bye.